Welcome to a new episode of Breaking Blocks. Today, me and Fusion, we are going to build a villager breeder. Or Fusion, I'm going to help him. And we are building that because we want a villager that can trade us mending and Frostwalker books. So, we decided to just put it in this area. Over here. Or do you think it's okay? It is okay area to have it?
Yeah.
Yeah. So we are just going to make this area a bit easier to work on, and then we will bring the villager that are over there. We are going to take them over here. And yeah, we just start with that. So now all the villagers have made babies, and we have made this loop that every time a baby villager baby comes, it will fall down here, and when it grows up, it will go up here and fall down there. So the adults, they are staying there while babies are going in, so it's kind of a loop. So now I'm going to take this away because we have 30... We have 38. You see that here. So here is one villager. Yeah, see? There's one there. But that's cool. It's lots of stuff that way. Oh, so yeah, it's enough villagers. We don't need I think it's enough oh, please don't make more babies. I hope they don't make more babies. So I'm not sure how I'm going to do this now. Oh, I have to turn down the sound. It's so loud. Oh my god. I saw. I think maybe I just take... Oh, I don't have a bucket of water, but I can do like this. Oh, I hope it... Oh, Mala was on. Like that, and... Oh, do I have to make more? And just so, and now they can't go. So now if they make babies, they won't fall down here, because I think I even can kill, because I think it's too many. I think it's 38, we don't need that much. Yeah. Now it's 37. I think that is plenty, because I don't remember how many, but I think 40, then you get many villagers per hour. And yeah. Oh, let's see. So now I'm going to start on the other thing. So this is what we have done. The villager, they are breeding, and the babies, when they grow up, they will then go into this tube. And when they come down here, we have to press this pressure plate, so they will be shut up in a minecart, and then they will fall in the minecart here. And then they will... I wonder...
What? Where are you?
I'm on top. I wonder if the fence has to be... Oh no, of course, we haven't built it yet. But I think we have to take away the water in for now, and just place it down after. I think maybe that's easier. But this is how we are going to build it. This is not our design. It's Espedia, or what's his name? I will link the...
Something YouTube.
Yeah, something YouTube. I will link his video in the description down below. And this design is just something we have made ourselves, because we tried the different types of design, and designed for that video, it didn't work, so we made up this one. And I tried it in a test world and it worked, so yeah. So here are the two babies. When they grow up, they will then start swimming up, and you see that... Oh, shit. Oops. Now I just pressed a lot of minecarts out. Order! Stupid minecarts. And yeah, so they will swim up, but we have not water there. It's just so we don't get so many villagers down here right now. So we are going to continue building this. Maybe I can show you how. Or I can just... You need to have it like this. So, you will stand here to trade with them. Oh! That was the wrong button. So you will stand... There! Damn it! Here. And if you don't like the trade, you just... Oh, block lag. Or lag. Server lag, probably. So then they will fall down here. And here we are going to have water that leads them into... I don't know. Lava or cactus or something. So when the babies grow up, they will float here and go there and fall down here. And when they stay, when they are standing there, we just press on this, and a minecart will. Of course, it didn't work. Nah, what? It haven't. Why? Go. Okay. So, and then he will go. And I fall into here, and then we can trade with him. So this guy, he actually is 16 wool, then you get 1 emerald. That's kind of... Yeah, then you can trade emeralds. So, but something is up here. Let's see. When they sit in a minecart and then go, this spot here, they always stop. So we have to give them a little notch, or push them
a nudge.
Yeah, a nudge. Push them a little bit. Ooh, this is awkward. So, I'm not sure how we can fix that. Maybe we can... Like, now we are only going to... We are only going to be here while we are doing this, so... Yeah, I don't think it's it doesn't matter much for us, because we are not like building a automatic villager farm. So let's see if oh, so many babies. Whoa. So we feed them from here. I don't know why I put these here. I just wanted to see how they looked like. Yeah. So let's see. This guy, he's actually pretty good. I don't know if 24 emerald is the cheapest, but the unfortunate tree book, that's something I want to let... I'm not going to kill him. And this guy, he's kind of sucky. Power 1 we can kill, probably. I don't know, maybe we should maybe we should trade with these guys and see if...
You can do that!
Yeah, I'm going to try to open some of them. And let's see, I saw somebody... Yeah, Infinity. I'm going to put a sign here. Do like this. I just put a sign if they have a very good book. Was it like this? Infinite or E? No, it was E. and fin I think it was spelled like that.
I don't know. I suck in
English. I suck in English. In fin E.T. I wrote it wrong. In fin A.T. Frick! Oh. Is my microphone far away from my voice?
No.
Oh. Punch. Efficiency. Yeah. So I'm just going to trade with them and then we will see what we will get.
This is how to not use your potato farm.
So downstairs under the villager breeding station we have a potato farm that is to feed a villager because they need food to breed.
Hey, the villagers, eh?
Yeah.
Pita?
Pita, call Pita right away. So it's pretty big. I think it's big enough. Oh my god. Now we are going to try this little farm. Look at all the taters! Come on, taters!
Hey, what the fuck?
What? Oh!
What?
Oh, maybe I'm going to turn it off. Didn't it get the redstone signal, the last one?
Turn it again.
Oh, okay.
Because last time it worked fine.
Oh.
I see the problem. I need a repeater.
Do you have one on you? What?
No, but there's one here.
Let's see. How many did we get?
No!
4 and 3. Yeah, now it's complete. But now 2 is on.
I just fucked. Take the lever on off.
Okay.
One more time. Oh man, what?
Why these 4 here, they are not on. Why?
I don't know.
What have you done? No, <I'm> just kidding. That's probably a easy fix for it. Why is this one in love?
Because they're making babies, you know.
With him? He's not allowed. You're not allowed.
I told you. They do it sometimes down here as well.
What? You pervs. So So Mala, he's going to make a bigger sugarcane farm. It's for the trading thing for the villager. Because
I'll
these two...
make it the room one more block bigger this way.
Okay. So he's going to make it, and because those two small ones, they are really slow and bad. And the sugarcane just fly all over the place. So now the sugarcane farm is finished. This is the bigger one. Mala made this one. So he's going to explain how it works.
Hello everyone. This is stackable, though you can stack it backwards or upwards or do whatever you want with it. We just made it this size because we don't need anything more at the moment. And yeah. It's a very simple farm. It works as a block of code every time you sugarcane spawns. Doesn't matter where. The redstone is pretty simple as well.
Yeah, you only need
a down under here for the sugarcane to be able to grow. I guess that's pretty much it.
Yeah. And of course, if you want to build this one, you can. You only need 4 redstone blocks, 4 repeaters, and then redstone on top here, all the way.
You also need sticky pistons on the redstone blocks and regular pistons wherever the sugarcane is gonna grow.
Yeah. And we have it, or Mala has built this 8 blocks
this
long.
This particular farm is 32 blocks of sugarcane that is gonna grow.
Yeah. And if you want it to be more silent, you can of course make a water source block under here. We have just put like one water source that's run all the way, but if you want the water to be silent, you can make it like that, if you want to. And then, do you want to come up? We just connected this with hoppers to this chest, so the sugarcane from this one will fall into here and go to the chest, and that one will go to this chest. But they were so small and so slow, so we need more sugarcane to trade with the villagers. And now we have finally gotten, we have 1 fortune tree, Frostwalker 2. Let's see. Yeah, this one. And we have Infinity, Power 5. I think it was expensive. Yeah, not that expensive. And this is the good one, Mending. But he wants... let's see, 32 emerald and 1 book, so that is not a bad deal for that. And bottle of this one, he was really cheap with a bottle of enchanting, only 3 emeralds. I think maybe that's the cheapest one, maybe. It's the cheapest one I have seen. And now?
Now we're gonna get a new one.
Yeah, this one is going to fall down here. Sometimes we see babies down here, then we have to go down and kill them. I think we have these guys a little bit too close to this one. We should have it a little bit out, but the tutorial for this farm, we
this
have...
This one has a feather falling 2 book to start off with.
Oh. Yeah, we will trade with him and see what his last trade is. If it's bad, then we just kill him, and if it's good, then we keep him. So the one we have signed about, they are villagers we are going to keep, like, we are not going to kill them. Like this one, he has Infinity, that is kind of hard to get, so... And it's only 13 emeralds for it, and 1 book. I don't know, only a crappy Bane of Atropos. So, yeah. And if you want more villagers, you can just feed them and they make babies. But if you want to make this farm, I will recommend you to get them transported a bit away from this breeding station. They don't, I don't think they said it in the tutorial, because they had it like we are having it now, like right next to it. And it's not that good that they are breeding kids here, because this one dude, this one, Fortune 3, one time a baby grew up inside him or her, that villager. That was kind of bad, and it was hard to kill it, but we did it. And this design is something we made ourselves, because the design they showed, it didn't work, or they wouldn't go in the minecart. So we have just what is it called, the dispenser there, that shoots minecart, and when it shoots out the minecart, and if there is a villager here, the villager will be transported up here and fall into the water. And one thing he don't say in the tutorial is that they will not fall down in this first one, because they will come so fast in the minecart, like in super speed and psh, out in the water. So he just recommend you to have two fence gates here, and then start the farm. He don't say that. It's rarely that someone fall down there. That was kind of annoying. I thought that they will come a bit slower because of this one. Anywho, so that is going to be it for this episode. Soon we will do the dragon fight. Wonder very excited to do that one. So we will see. Hopefully it will
Dragon's
be
going down.
Yeah, hopefully it will be next week, and hopefully we will find those wings. So see you in the next episode. Bye.